Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and protect us all, inshallah ta'ala. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Please, if you did not subscribe yet, subscribe to our channel and support EPIC during this COVID-19 pandemic, inshallah. Tonight we have a dua that most of us know it by heart already, but some of us do not know maybe the meaning of it, and maybe some of us also do not know the reward behind it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with the Sahaba and he told them, I'm going to teach you a dua that no Muslim ever say this dua illa istajab Allah lah. Ma da'a bihi Muslim qat illa istajab Allah lah. No Muslim ever makes this dua except Allah Azza wa Jal will answer his dua. Allahu Akbar. What is that dua? Before I mention the dua, there's a beautiful story behind it. In the time when Umar radiallahu anhu wa ardah was the Khalifa, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas walked into the Masjid and he saw Uthman radiallahu anhu in the Masjid. And he said, As-salamu alayka ya Uthman. He said salam to Uthman. Uthman did not reply. Sa'd radiallahu anhu said, As-salamu alayka ya Uthman. Uthman did not reply. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu was surprised, was shocked. So he immediately went to the Khalifa, to Umar radiallahu anhu. Imagine if somebody did not reply the salam, they used to report it to the Khalifa. This is how important it is. So he went to Umar radiallahu anhu and said, Ya Umar, hal hadatha shay' fil Islam? Anything happened in Islam? He said, why? Nothing happened. He said, I saw Uthman in the Masjid and I said salam to him and he did not reply. Umar radiallahu anhu was surprised. So he said, get me Umar, get Uthman over here. Uthman came. He said, Ya Uthman, Sa'd is saying that he said salam to you more than once at the Masjid and you did not reply to him. Uthman said, this did not happen. Allahu Akbar. You're talking about three people, three men who are mubashareen bil Jannah. So yani lying is out of the question. So Sa'd looked at Uthman and said, Ya Uthman, you were sitting in the Masjid and I said Assalamu alaikum more than once and you looked me in the eye and you did not respond. And after Sa'd insisted that he said salam, Uthman radiallahu anhu said, Ya Allah, yes, yes, yes. You know, absolutely, forgive me, my brother, forgive me. I was thinking of something that made me not notice your salam. You know, when you're looking at somebody sometimes and you're actually looking at them, but you are thinking about something else, huh? This is exactly what happened with Uthman. So Sa'd said to Uthman, what was it you were thinking about that made you so distracted that you don't even reply my salam? So Uthman said, remember one day we were sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, I am going to teach you a dua. Ma da'a bihi Muslim qat. No Muslim ever say this dua except Allah will answer him. And then a Bedouin came in and asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a question. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgot to tell us what that dua. And since that day, subhanAllah, listen, my brothers and sisters, now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have passed away, Abu Bakr have passed away, and now we are in the Khilafah of Umar, and Uthman is still thinking about that time. Allahu Akbar. So I've been thinking, what was that dua? SubhanAllah. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu, and who is Sa'd? Sa'd is the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, so he said, oh, I remember, absolutely. I definitely remember that meeting. And that's why after everybody is gone, I followed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his house. And I said, Ya Rasulullah, we were sitting with you and then you said, I'm going to teach you a dua no Muslim ever say except he will be answered, and then the Bedouin came and you get distracted. What is that dua, Ya Rasulullah? Subhanallah. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, yes, it is the dua of my brother Yunus. La ilaha illa anta, subḥānaka, innī kuntu minaẓ-ẓālimīn. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa anta, subḥānaka, innī kuntu minaẓ-ẓālimīn. Wallahi, we need this dua all through our life, but specifically and especially in the time that we are going through right now. La ilaha illa anta, subḥānaka, innī kuntu minaẓ-ẓālimīn. Yunus alayhi salam made this dua, and subhanallah, he was in three darknesses: the darkness of the night, the darkness of the ocean, and the darkness of the belly of the whale. Inside three darknesses, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua. Yunus alayhi salam was going through so much difficulty, and he begged Allah Azza wa Jal with this dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua. Now, let's explain the wording of the dua and then some lessons from this dua. La ilaha illa ant. Yunus alayhi salam started by the most important kalima in our life. He confirmed the tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal. La ilaha illa ant. He confirmed that there's no ilah worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why the earth is being created, and the Jannah and Jahannam has been created, and that's why the prophets have been sent, all because of that word, La ilaha illallah. So Yunus alayhi salam started by admitting and confessing and proving that he is in complete belief that there's no God worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa anta, subhanak, subhanallah. This word subhanak, we say it every single day, subhana rabbi al-azim, subhana rabbi al-ala. First, we cannot use this word except with Allah Azza wa Jal. I cannot say subhan Ahmad, subhan Mahmud, subhan Muhammad. No. This word is only used with Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanallah. Second, what does subhana mean? Subhana is one of these words that you cannot have just one word as a translation. Subhana means, it literally means that I believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect in every attribute and free from any deficiency. All this statement together means subhana. Allahu Akbar. Allah is perfect in every attribute. Allah is perfect in His vision, in His hearing, in His knowledge, in His wisdom, in His power, in every attribute. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free from any deficiency. Allah does not need food, does not need drink. Allah does not get tired. Allah does not need to sleep. Allah does not need any help. All that is in subhana. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu minaẓ-ẓālimīn. First, he confirmed the tawheed. Second, he glorified Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he admitted that I am from the zalimeen. I am from the wrongdoers. I am from the zalimeen. Dhulm, oppression, dhulm, is putting something in a place that it does not belong to. Now, Yunus alayhi salam, let's take the few lessons. Number one, no matter what action that you have done, you know, because we are allowed in Islam to use our a'mal as-saliha as a wasila, as means to ask Allah by. I can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by a amal that I have done. I can ask Him by that amal to fulfill a need that I have. We all know the story or the hadith of the three men in the cave. When they were in the cave and they were stuck in the cave, they told each other, let's every single one of us ask Allah with the best amal he has ever done to remove the rock. So everyone asked somebody. So we learn from this hadith that we are allowed to ask Allah Azza wa Jal with our righteous deeds to fulfill something. For example, Ya Allah, because of that yatim, that orphan I sponsored, Ya Allah, cure my mother, for example. Okay, grant me a righteous husband. I can use that. But there's nothing, there's no amal, there's nothing that we have better than the tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal to use to ask Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. So this is exactly how Yunus alayhi salam started. La ilaha illa anta. He started with the kalima of tawheed. The most important thing in our life is La ilaha illallah. He started using that tawheed to ask for help in the hardship that he is in. Second, did you notice that Yunus alayhi salam did not ask Allah, Ya Allah, save me. Ya Allah, get me out of this belly. Ya Allah, bring me back. Ya Allah, nothing. La ilaha illa anta, subḥānaka, innī kuntu minaẓ-ẓālimīn. Here, there's this dua displays how much Yunus alayhi salam is in need. It displays how weak he is and how poor he is. And this is one of the etiquettes of dua, and this is how we can have our dua being answered. He used the thana of Allah Azza wa Jal. This dua here is not a dua of request, Allahumma I want this, Allahumma I want that. No, he just praised Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, knowing that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is the alim. He knows what he's going through. He just praised Allah Azza wa Jal and admitted that he's a wrongdoer, and he left it to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And this is a lesson here. My brothers and sisters, we, and this is, subhanAllah, what we learned from this whole pandemic that we're going through. We just ask Allah Azza wa Jal and we leave it to Him. The how and the when and the what and where, leave it to Allah Azza wa Jal. This is not your business. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala knows when is the best time, where is the best time, how it's going to be done. But leave it to Allah and put your trust in Him. He just said, La ilaha illa ant. He did not say, Ya Allah, take me out of here. Ya Allah, get me out of this darkness. Ya Allah, get me out of the ocean. Ya Allah, get me out of the belly. He did not say any of that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right after that, He said, Fastajabna lah. We answered Him. Allahu Akbar. So this is a lesson. Praise Allah. Like for example, I give an example, and to Allah belongs the best example. You go to somebody who is very well known to be rich, powerful, extremely generous, extremely kind. And you go to him and you say, oh, you are so amazing, you are so kind, you are so loving, you are so generous. You keep on praising and praising him. You don't have to ask anything. And he knows that, and you show that you are in need. By himself, he will give you whatever you want. By himself, he knows that you are in need. SubhanAllah. How about Allah Azza wa Jal, the Alim, the Khabir, the Hakim, the one who knows exactly what you need more than yourself. SubhanAllah. So this is exactly what Yunus alayhi salam did, and this is what we're supposed to do. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal, we show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how poor we are to Him. We show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how much we are in need to Him, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we leave it to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That does not mean I'm not allowed to ask, cure me, give me this, give me that. No, absolutely. There are so many other dua that we request specific things. But here, this kind of dua, and subhanAllah, keep in mind, Rasulullah said, no one who makes this dua except Allah will answer. Third, subhanAllah, a prophet, my brothers and sisters, listen carefully. A prophet is admitting that he is from the wrongdoer. And some of us are so arrogant, they do not admit their mistakes. A prophet is admitting that he wronged himself. Allahu Akbar. So when we are, and which we are, sinners, we have to admit, Ya Allah, I've done this and I've done that. Ya Allah, please forgive me. Ya Allah, I have wronged myself so much, Ya Allah. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. SubhanAllah, we have wronged ourselves so much, Ya Allah. كُلُّنَا, every single one of us, every single person who's watching right now, is a sinner. We are all sinners. And we have to admit, oh, what have I done to ask? No. Humble yourself, ya akhi. A prophet is saying that he is from the zalimeen. SubhanAllah. Tayyib. Now, is this only for Yunus alayhi salam? No. Why? Because look at the, listen to the ayah right after that. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمْ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We answered him and we saved him from this affliction, and similarly we will save the mu'mineen. May Allah make me and you from the mu'mineen. If we are from the mu'mineen, from the believers, and we also make this dua insha'Allah ta'ala, Allah will answer us. So that does not mean this is the dua is only for Yunus. This is for everybody who is in need and everybody who is making this dua sincerely from the bottom of their heart. And he is, and she is, a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said after the dua of Yunus alayhi salam, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. This fa in Arabic, it's called fa al-fawriya. Instant fa. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We instantly answered him. Somebody might say, I've been making this dua and I'm making the la ilaha illa anta subḥānaka innī kuntu minaẓ-ظالمين, but I'm not getting فَاسْتَجَبْنَا. I'm not getting the answer. Why? We have to check few things, which are the etiquettes of dua in general. In order for the dua to be mustajab, it has to be from sincerely from the heart. It has to be done with yaqeen, with certainty that you have no doubt in your heart that Allah is capable of granting you what you're asking for. You have to have, very important, you have to have halal income. One of the main reasons why the dua is not mustajab is the haram income, haram wealth. That will prevent the dua from being mustajab. So there are certain things that has to be done in order for the dua to be mustajab. Now, what did, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many prophets, Nuh, Zakariya, and every Ayyub, and every single one after them, he said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا. We answered them. What was something so special about them that their dua was mustajab? May Allah make all our dua mustajab. Listen carefully in the ayat after that.
إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ.
They used to do three things. That's why their dua was mustajab. كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. Not they used to do good things. They used to race to do good things. Allahu Akbar. Now we are in a time that many people are in need. Wallahi, a brother called me today. He said, subhanAllah, wallahi, I almost cried. He said, I'm done. I finished. Everything is finished. Money, stuff in the house, I'm done. SubhanAllah. What can I do? I spoke to him and I calmed him down. I tried to get him something, inshaAllah ta'ala, to keep him surviving. But there are many people, this brother at least, he reached a point to make a call. There are many who are not making that call, or they don't have anybody to make that call to. So this is the time to race and rush and help others as much as you can. This is a test for all of us. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. And not فِي الْخَيْرِ, خَيْرَات, plural, all kinds, all means of khayr. يُسَارِعُونَ, سَارِع, سَارَعَ, سَارِعُ, from rushing, from speeding, subhanAllah, يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَات. This is one of the reasons for the dua to be answered, so to be from the people who rush to do good things. Second, وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. And they used to make dua to us, call upon us, رغباً, hoping that Allah will answer, and at the same time, رهباً, and they are afraid that Allah might not answer. You know, they are worried because they are maybe they fear their sins, and at the same time, and same time, they have so much hope in Allah's rahmah, so they used to make a lot of tadarru', a lot of begging to Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is exactly what we're supposed to be doing right now, a lot of dua to Allah Azza wa Jal, begging him for forgiveness, begging him to accept. This is what we are supposed to be doing, a lot of it, and a lot of the dua that we learned today. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. And what's the last thing they used to do? Wa kanu lana khashi'in. And they used to be khashi'in. We all know the word khashi' from the khushu' in the salat. And they used to be humble. They were never arrogant. They used to caring with the poor, loving to the miskeen, helping the orphan, helping the widows, helping anyone in need. Khashi'in, and also khashi'in, they used to be having khushu' in their salat. They used to pray slowly. And inshallah ta'ala, one day we will make a talk about the importance of praying slowly in the salat and how to achieve khushu' in the salat. وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. So three things used to do. يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ, rush and race to do good things. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا, and they used to make a lot of dua, a lot of dua, sincere dua to Allah Azza wa Jal. And وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ, and they used to be humble. All these three, we need them right now in order to have that لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين, to have that dua مستجاب. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. So anytime you're going through any kind of hardship, and we are in a major hardship right now, constantly 10, 20, 50, 100, 500 times, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Say it like you mean it. Say it like Yunus عليه السلام. He was in a situation, in a place that no human being ever have been to, in a difficulty that nobody has ever been in such a difficulty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got him out of that, and Allah promised that we will do the same to the believers. So please, say this dua from the bottom of your heart, sincerely, slowly, slowly, as many times as you can. And if you want, for example, you have, my father is sick. Ya Allah, cure my father. Ya Allah, and you make all your dua, and you end your dua by لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. If you want to say it in plural, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. Just add the alif and the alif to إني and كنت. Instead of kuntu, you say kunna. So please memorize this dua. Tell everybody about this dua. This dua by itself is an ayah in the Quran. I think it's ayah 87 in Surah Al-Anbiya. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our dua. La ilaha illa anta subhanak inna kunna min al-zalimeen. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive all our sins. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bring us back to our masajid. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite our hearts and grant us to be under his shade when there's no shade except his shade. جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.